Hi guys, I'm Adrian from the EdenAI team, and today I'm going to show you how to implement your own chatbot on your website. You probably need a chatbot for a customer to give them more information about what you do, and today I'm going to show you how you can do it easily. This video will be separated in three different parts. The first part will be the Ask Yoda part. I will tell you and explain you what it is on EdenAI. The second part will be a tutorial to implement the embed. I will explain you also what is an embed, but I will show you how to implement this embed in Webflow, or you can do it on any other CMS you want. And the last part will be to implement this embed into your own website you are trying to develop. I don't know, in different language or framework, for example, React, Vue, or natively with HTML, CSS in JavaScript. So let's dive into it. So let's dive into the first part. The first thing you will need to do is to create a free account on EdenAI. The link is in the description section. After you created an account, you will arrive to this platform. You will need to go to the workflow section, Ask Yoda feature. So what is Ask Yoda? Basically, Ask Yoda is a feature that empowers you to create your own chatbot with your own data. For example, you need a support service. You're selling online clothes, and people want to know what kind of clothes, what is the delivery area. So a lot of questions, but basic question that you shouldn't be necessarily implicated to answer it. So, like, you will be able to give all this those information into the Ask Yoda, and people could just ask the feature what are the clothes available, some stuff like that. So, the first thing you will need to do in your Ask Yoda is to create a new project if you don't have one. I will create a new one. I will name it Ask Yoda. Create a quick start and create a new project. So I'm arriving to the panel. You will have several information, but firstly, we're going to check if Yoda is empty. So I will ask him a basic question. What is the color of my new bike? And he shouldn't be able to answer it because I didn't give him the information. As an AI, I don't have access to personal data. Perfect. Now we want to give to the Ask Yoda project some data to give him some information to fill him with information. So you can upload files. You will have three different type of content you can upload. You can upload some file, PDF, CSV, MP3. You will be also able to upload some text, or you can upload some URL of a website. For example, you want to upload the life of, I don't know, Mark Zuckerberg. You can do it by just copy and paste the Wikipedia link. But for the moment, we will just go to the text section. I will give him the information. My new bike is red. Upload data. And after that, I will be able to regenerate the question. So, what is the color of my new bike? And the color of your new bike is red. So perfect. Now you understand what is my new bike. So now that I've uploaded the basic information, I can upload also CSV, as I said before. So I'll pick a basic one. I will pick the audio providers for the different provider we have for the audio features. And I will also be able to upload some PDF. You can here find all the different files you have uploaded and delete them and remove them from your project. And now I can ask what, for example, what are the different what are the available providers for the audio features. Yeah, it has worked perfectly. So like we have all the different stuff we have uploaded. So let's now go to the second part of this video, and it will be about how to implement the chatbot into your website. After we saw how to create your own AskUDA project, let's have it in the second part where I will explain you how to implement the chatbot into your website. So currently I'm using for my website a CMS. You can choose any other CMS you want, but you will need to have the ability to add some custom code. So the custom code you will need to add is in the link of the GitHub. So click on the link and go to the part of usability, copy this line, and go to the place where you can add custom code. In Webflow, you just gonna click on the settings here, go to the custom code and add this line to your photo code, for example, because it's in the body tag. So you will have to replace some values. Here you will have to replace the project ID. So the project ID is in EdenAI, sorry. You will have to copy it and paste it here. Perfect. You will also have to change your provider. So for this project, I will use OpenAI, but you can choose any other provider you want. And I will choose also for the model, I will choose GPT-4, and the number of chunk I want to be returned. I advise you to put the basic number, but you can choose any other number you want, but I will put the default one, so it will be 5. I will save it. So for the moment, this is what it's at. I don't have any chatbot, and now I have to publish it into my website. Perfect. And now if I refresh the page, perfect, I can see now that I have my chatbot here. So I can click it and I can ask also my last question. What is the color? What is the color of my new bicycle, my new bike? And it should be answering me red. Yeah, perfect. So now we have seen how to implement it into a CMS. So now let's see how to implement it into your custom website. So now I will show you how to add your chatbot into your custom website you are developing in React, in Vue, or in HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So I'm going to go to my editor. So here's my project. Like it's a basic website. There is anything working, it's just for the demonstration. So I will pass the value of here. So copy this and paste it here. And for the moment, if I go back here, now we can see there is my assistant, but I can add some custom stuff to it. So the first message, the title to replace about AI assistant, and the color. So here I have the opportunity to add the title, for example. So I can here add title. Title is equal to I have to make simple quote. I can change to GPT assistant or ask Yoda. My mistake. Assistant. Yo. Now it should work. I have to remove the code. Perfect. Assistant. So now if we check, like, we have changed the title. We can also change, as we see in the GitHub, we can also change the message, the first message. So I will add another parameter. Message. It could be hello there, for example, with exclamation mark. Hello there. Perfect. And I can change the color of my button. So I will change it to make it more suitable to the website. So I will change to this color. I have an extension that gives me that color. It's this color. And I have to add it into the RGB format. So I have to add the color. Color is equal to RGB value, and it will be 255, if I remember well, 48 and 20, and it should work perfectly. Like, now I have my button the same color as my other button, and now I can chat and still ask what is the color of my new bike, and it will answer me well. I hope. Yeah, perfect. It answered me well. So now that we have seen how to implement the chatbot into your own website, that will be the end of this video. If you have any question or any request regarding Edenai features, leave a comment. If you have any need of information about this project, or you want to discover more about Edenai, you can see our blog on our website. The link is in the description. Have a nice day.